great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Montana State Fighting Bobcats and the Oklahoma Sooners. Number 23 is the freshman sensation that will be expected to carry a big part of the load for his team tonight.
This is one of the few kids in the nation who can take over a game at the offensive and defensive ends of the floor.
The Sooners will undoubtedly feed off his play in this contest. The Sooners should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them, though?
Hey, here's my keys for them tonight. Number one, play at your own tempo. Don't get into a run-and-gun game, baby. Second, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. Thirdly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Trying to feed inside. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork, really excellent on a post block. Ooh, look at the shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
With a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Steal. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
That's a good job trying to foul off the pro hop, lad.
Well, the defender really didn't have a choice. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Woods goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Gave it up. The center handles the pass. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Moving it around the perimeter. In the paint. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, before the game, the coach stressed to me this could happen. He told me it's so important for the supporting cast to get involved and not really rely on their one player. Right now, he's trying to get everyone on the bench on the same page.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Looking for a good shot. Takes away the pass. Dumps it in, and there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? They look to get it to the inside. Palmer fakes the shot. Executes the baby hook.
Ante, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land.
High step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Barishnikov in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Takes the pass in the paint. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Shoots from the elbow. Way off target. There's the fake. Here's a spin down in the low block.
Conte's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and add a spin move to the goal.
With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand.
Trying to go inside.
The student section is all rallied up, and they are ready to battle.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
The small forward receives the pass. Oh, yes.
We'll get a better look on the replay. Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Number 23 has got the people in the bleachers up in appreciation.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
Turnaround jumper. And in and out. Shot clock is dead. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He pushes it hard up the court. Trying to draw the foul. Doesn't go. Cotton handles the feed. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Can't get it to go. Ball goes out of play. At the half, the Bobcats are ahead by two. Oklahoma seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Start of the second half, Dick, our focused player update. What's he got to get done in the second half for them to win?
I would run them off screens on the right and left. I would set up screens and have them pop out to shoot that trifecta.
The crowd really admires this young man.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
On the outside, the shooting guard receives the ball. There's the pick. There's the roll. Cotton picks up the defensive foul. First team foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. That's from a nylon NBA.
It away. Woods, while applying pressure, goes for the aggressive steal.
In addition to the pressure defense, they're going for some aggressive steals as well.
Defensively trying to stay with his man, and he's going to pick up a foul.
What a poor job defensively. Very slow inside, and they attack him aggressively.
The post flashes up high if he wants it from way outside. Not this time. Gave it up.
Nice fake.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
On the dribble, gives it up. And the ball goes out of play. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Working it around the perimeter. From the top of the key. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Gave it up. For two. Perfectly executed. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He unloads. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Right now it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Looking for a good shot. Entry pass in the paint. He puts it in with contact and all.
That's incredible.
Here's makes the block. He's trying to speed up the tempo of this game.
It's not uncommon to have a few high risers on your team these days. The game has definitely changed in that regard.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad, despite his performance, he has been unable to get his teammates all on the same page. There's a lot of confusion and lack of focus down here right by the bench. He continues to stress to them, relax, play your game. He can't do this alone, Brad.
Thanks, Aaron. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the run.
He rejects it. I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting it.
Well, it's the keys to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. 5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving this building without a fight, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Rims out. Pushes it up. Lee is animated and ready to go.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
On the dribble, gives it up. That's a foul. And he's going to pick up the foul and all. Look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They work it around the perimeter. Count that as a personal foul. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Goes up for two. Easy one. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
Tries for two.
They need to foul here.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling, Brad.
And the clock stopped with a foul. They will line them up. Gets it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Second one, no good.
It's a key possession. They must score here, baby.
For the deuce, he buries the shot. Shot clock is dead. The Bobcats are now in the bonus.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Foul, man, that stops the clock again. He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Gets the second. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Back to the action now in a half court. Let's see what they set up, Dick. Moving it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. Off the rim and no good. Basket falls despite the contact. And yet another foul. And here's a look at the foul situation.
Well, Brad, fouling and knowing when the foul is an important part of the game. If you have fouls to give, sometimes it's better to commit one rather than giving up an easy basket.
Gets his first. Hits the second shot. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
He looks for three.
They have to foul to put them on the line. I hope they miss.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
He steps up to the line. First one is no good. Second one is no good.
Timeout on the floor. It's a close one. The trigger fingers are getting itchy, baby. This one's too close to call.
It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Basket's good. That's goaltending. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Oklahoma loses in a close game.
After a loss like this, you have to question their ranking.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.